So Apple have just updated their terms of service regarding NFT integration into the iOS App Store. And in this video, we're going to break down what that means and why this may stifle growth for Web3. So here are the main breakdown points. So any app utilizing the iOS App Store can now allow NFT in-app purchases to sell and sell services related to NFTs. So things like minting, listing NFT items, or even transferring them. An app can also allow its users to view their own NFTs or view the NFT of others. However, this is provided that the NFT does not unlock additional utility within the app. The terms also state that users can browse NFT collections of other users, but as long as the app does not direct customers to external links or other purchasing mechanisms other than in-app purchases. What this is in service of here is that NFT transactions will be subject to the 30% Apple tax, as it's known, which is a 30% fee on any in-app commerce. Any violation of these Apple guidelines would lead to potentially your app being removed from the App Store. And so this is being widely regarded now as something that can actually hinder NFT purchases and development of Web3 via apps. So breaking this down, if an app is not allowed to have an NFT in it that gives any form of additional utility, then they're pretty much simply saying you can only have JPEGs, the most simplest form of NFT. And the kind of utility behind NFTs goes way beyond that now. As we've seen with projects like Bored Ape Yacht Club, the ability for your NFT to allow you to mint a sequence of that NFT, such as the Bored Ape Kennel Club. And if we look at the current landscape for the most actively used NFTs in games right now, think of a weapon as an example here, well, that directly gives you additional utility to the app. So by their own terms, a weapon, an in-game asset, would not be allowed to be sold on an iOS application. Also, the fees involved here are very hefty. 30% for Apple is rather disgusting. We've even seen criticism for the likes of OpenSea charging 2.5% on NFT purchases as being seen as a bit high, but 30% really does take the biscuit. And the language used within this, that buttons or external links or other calls to action, i.e. not letting users circumvent the Apple tax here, is boldly being stated, and further reiterated is the fact that crypto is not an option for payment. So back in May of this year, Elon spoke up about this, saying that the Apple Store is like having a 30% tax on the internet. It's such a foundational piece for any thriving app, and then monopolizing at the software level here really is a serious hindrance for NFT adoption. Now, in a positive spin, Leonidas posted this earlier. After a multi-year battle, the largest company on earth, i.e. Apple, just updated its terms of service to allow for the sale of NFTs in apps. He states that the first crack in Apple's multi-trillion dollar walled garden just appeared, but others are not so understanding. Enter the CEO of Epic Games, Tim Sweeney here. He posted to cryptocurrency enthusiasts, "This means Apple is now adding a 30% tax on your so-called true ownership of digital goods." And to the cryptocurrency detractors, "This shows Apple's motivations are only money. For digital items, they support the NFTs that they can tax, and they ban the NFTs that they don't tax." So this is a pretty clear statement of intent that Apple wants to have the so-called Apple tax, that 30% payment baked into absolutely everything NFT based on their platform. And this is going to provide a serious headache for app developers in the Web3 space who are hoping to lean on NFTs to build community and some epic products. But just checking in on the Apple chart here, you can see it is still in a bullish posturing over the last few days here. And with this announcement, plus the iOS 16.1 upgrade that just went live, which stated that any social media boosts, i.e. promotion of social media posts, think Twitter, all of these boosts will now have to pay the 30% Apple tax as they must go through in-app purchases. So Apple clearly trying to claw up even more revenue here in what seems to be a highly money motivated set of moves. So drop me a comment down below. What do you think of this? Is this just egregious behavior from Apple? Will this slow down Web3 adoption and stifle innovation? Or is this just the first baby steps towards Apple having full NFT integration and greater access for end consumers? I'd love to hear your thoughts down below. Subscribe if you're new, guys. I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye.